What's up, Peep Squad? Peep Squad is in the building, baby. Please like, comment, subscribe, share the video. It'd be greatly appreciated. Let's get down to the situation. Let's talk about Kim Zolciak Bierman. Baby, it is going down when it comes to the family tree. It is going down when it comes from the apple don't fall too far from the tree. And this is just Lord have mercy. Look what Bravo done did. They done made this lady a sore. And baby, it is a sad situation. But let's get on to the situation. When it comes to Kim's father, Joseph, he was arrested on Monday for battery. And his bond was $1,000, baby. He had to wait until Tuesday night to get out because they had to come up with the $50 bill, y'all, to get him out. In any event, So let's just talk about this situation. So this is how the story goes. This is what Page Six is actually saying. Page Six is saying that Joseph was... So in any event, when it gets down to the situation, Kim's father, Joseph, allegedly was arrested because he was involved in an altercation with his wife, Karen, which is Kim's mother. Her parents is out here in these streets wilding. And the situation goes like this. Kim's mother, Karen, ironic her name is Karen, was jealous and she was upset and she was mad at her husband, Joseph, because according to the police reports obtained by Page Six, Karen was feeling a certain type of way because her husband, Joseph, was outside talking to a neighbor, a female neighbor, and I guess that female neighbor looked good. I guess that female neighbor had something going on and she was out here popping and looking good. And her husband, Joseph, was having a conversation with her, and Karen did not like it at all. So she was upset. She tried to talk to Joseph, and Joseph basically wasn't hearing it. He was ignoring her, and he went out to run an errand. And then on top of that situation, you know, Kim's mother slammed the door. She was upset and she was mad. So she slammed the door and basically was mad and she was upset over the conversation. I was like, wow, you jealous, huh? You jealous after all these years? So in any event, when Joseph returned home from being out running errands, Karen went to go take a bath and Joseph was ignoring his wife. And you know, he was watching TV in the bedroom, or Karen was watching TV in the bedroom, which the police report states. And once Karen was done with her bath, she was feeling a certain type of way because her husband was ignoring her and she felt like she was going to lose her husband. So she wanted to have a conversation with him while he was sitting there watching TV. But in any event, she fell over, and allegedly Joseph may have something to do with her falling over or tumbling over. But the police report states that Kim's mother, Karen, was intoxicated. She had two glasses of wine. Lord have mercy. So they don't know if she stumbled because of Joseph may have pushed her, or she stumbled because she was, you know, drinking, allegedly. That's what the police report says, y'all. In any event, we already know her daughter loves to carry a red cup of wine around, a red cup with something inside of it that makes it get your body tingling, get you going, get you inebriated, and things of that nature. So therefore, it doesn't fall far from the tree. So mama was in the house in the middle of the day getting toasted, like Kim be getting toasted all day long that we see allegedly on TV in that red cup. So you guys let me know what you think about that situation. I was like, Lord have mercy, it is going down in this situation. This is crazy. So in any event, Kim's mother, Karen, she ended up stumbling over and falling. And when she did, you know, the cops were called because she alleged her husband pushed her because she wanted to make sure he was behind bars so he didn't go over there and talk to the neighbor. Something went down with the neighbor. I guess that neighbor must be young. The neighbor must look good or whatever the case may be. And when it comes to, you know, on Karen, she's probably feeling a certain type of way because she knows how her daughter is. Her daughter would be with a married man. So therefore, she's thinking that the neighbor would be with a married man too as well. So you guys let me know what you think about this situation. As you guys know, when it comes to Big Papa, Kim was dating Big Papa on the show. She was bragging about the money he was giving her. She was bragging about everything. And everybody was just loving it. Everybody was bigging up Big Papa. They was bigging up Kim. I was like, oh, Kim got the money. Kim know how to finesse. Kim is this. Kim is is that, I mean, they you know, put her on a pedestal that she was dating a married man. NeNe Leakes had to come out here and say, close your legs to married men. So in any event, a lot of the audience, a lot of the people were supporting Kim dating Big Papa, knowing that he was married. And they even tried to keep his identity from the show, but in any event, it came out. So you guys let me know what you think about that situation. She was praised, and then she ended up getting a spinoff show. But in any event, when it comes to Portia, people are dogging out Portia, saying Portia's no good, Portia's bad, Portia this and that. But yet, she did the same thing that Kim did. Kim was dating a married man. She didn't marry the married man because the married man, Big Papa, didn't want to leave his wife at the time, and there was a whole lot of money tied up. But in any event, Portia did the same thing. She ends up dating a married man. She didn't date him on the show. She dated him after the show. But, you know, the married man was connected to one of the other cast members, which is Fallon. You know, so in any event, you know, Kim was praised. People didn't dog Kim out. People was like, oh my God, who's Big Papa? What about their relationship? Oh, look what Big Papa brought her. Oh, Big Papa's taking care of her. Big Papa's getting her a house. Big Papa's moving her out of that apartment. Big Papa's doing that. And everybody was like, oh, I want a Big Papa. Now that Portia got a Big Papa, everybody's upset with Portia. Everybody's mad with Portia. They calling Portia all types of lowlife and disrespecting her, saying that, oh, she's this, she's that. But yet when Kim was doing it, everybody was congratulating her and putting her on a pedestal. But when it comes to Portia, oh, she's just a low scum of the earth. Like, Lord have mercy. So you guys tell me what you think about that situation. But in any event, let's get back to Kim's parents. Let's get back to the situation at hand. And in any event, Portia was not right in doing what she did. You know what I mean? It's not a good situation. But at the same time, Kim was, you know, getting accolades, and Portia's being dogged out by the public, and the public was giving Kim accolades. Not saying either situation is right, but Portia is engaged to the married man, and in any event, his wife is pregnant by another man that was actually, you know, working and actually an assistant in Simon's house, and Simon was paying him, baby. So it was almost allegedly like Fallon was cheating in the next room, allegedly, because that's what Simon said. Simon said she's pregnant and she's been with this guy Jalen Banks, baby, and it's been under his nose. So I guess he was out here and was like, the next best thing is to get Portia, and he sure did get her. But in any event, also, when you guys think about Kim, and we say, oh my God, Kim had so much surgery, Kim did so much to her face, Kim did this, Kim did that, and yes, she did a whole lot when it comes to what she looked like and when it comes to her face, baby. So if you look at Kim's mother, you understand why Kim does not really, you know, aspire to have her mother's genetics. And that's why she ends up doing all the work and going under the knife and seeing the doctor. Because if you look at her mother's genes, you look at her father's genes, she basically wants it to skip her. And also when it comes to Kim's daughter, you know, her oldest daughter, she basically wants the genes to skip her too as well, because she got a lot of work done as well too. So you guys let me know what you think about this situation. It seems like Kim don't want to look nothing like her mother, point blank period, at all. She done changed her whole look, but she do look, still look like her father. She definitely still look like her father, for real, for real. Ain't no holding it back, but she does look like her father. But let's continue with the situation when it comes to Kim's parents, you know, having an altercation at home. You don't think that Croy and Kim are living this lifestyle that her mother and her father's living? That apple doesn't fall far from the tree. So we already know there's probably trouble in paradise, allegedly, when it comes to Kim and Croy. It gotta be, because look at her genetics, look at everything. Her mother's sitting there drinking in the middle of the day, Kim is out here in the middle of the day with the red cup, baby, and got stuff in the red cup, and she's been holding that red cup for years, and basically leading us to believe that there's something else in that cup that will have you. So the situation that went down between Kim's parents, Karen and Joseph, it was just like, okay, somebody called the police. I don't know who called the police, because allegedly Kim's mother, she ends up hitting her head on an antique dining table, and that's what the report states. And they don't really know if it's because of her husband or is it because she was highly intoxicated, you know, because Kim's mother was actually, she was transported to the West Florida hospital because she was so intoxicated. And Karen admitted to having only two glasses of wine. if you only had 2 glasses of wine, you know, but she hit her head. So basically I had to make sure that she was okay. You know, they don't want her to lose conscious or go into a coma. But in any event, that's the situation that went down. This is why, you know, Kim's father was arrested, why Kim's mother, Karen, went to the hospital. So in any event, Joseph said he claims that Karen was blocking the TV when she fell, which is suspected because she was intoxicated. So basically, Joseph, Kim's father, was falsely arrested, and he was arrested for a misdemeanor battery and booked at the county jailhouse, and he was released on